Morning. This is a class. You have to find out that one to find the radius of curvature by spherometer in Newton's experiment. So how to find out the radius of curvature in spherometer? So just you have to observe that one. What is the spherometer here we have? So here we have that one. This is the spherometer we have. Generally you have to observe that one. That is a what is that one? Head scale you have that one, and pitch you have. That is a three legs you have. So one screw you have that one to find out this arrangement. This is the arrangement you have to find out the radius of curvature. So here that one you have to take out the plain glass plate, and here we have that one plano convex lens. You know that one how to find out the plano convex lens. While I am going to rotate, it freely is rotating that one. See, observe that one freely rotating. Maybe it's a curved surface. Now reverse it and observe that one. It is not freely moving that one called plane surface. Now keep that curved surface. This is the curved surface. What you are observing? Curved surface is stop. This is the curved surface is stop. For that one, you have to find out the radius of curvature here. So first, you go for that one. What is spherometer? Spherometer, you have that one here. So here you observe that one scale, and you have to observe that one here. That one round scale, you are going to observe that one. So first, you have to find out the least count. How to find out the least count? You have that one. Okay. So now first I'll go for that one error. We are going to find out error for the end error. That one, the spherometer you have to place on the glass plate. I have to place here that one. So just you observe that one. So downside screw will going to touch on the glass plate. So properly that one. So the screw will going to touch on the glass plate properly. So see that one, it is touching that one proper way. So it is touched that one. Now how to find out it is touched or not? Okay, we are going to find by using some paper. So we have to test here that one. So now it is not going inside that one more. So it is the way that one you have to find out the touched or not. Now you go for that. What is the values here that one? So we are finding that one just zero error. We are going to find here that one zero error. Now you are going to see observe that one. So in the scale you have to observe zero of this one head is matching with the zero of this one here the scale. Okay, vertical scale. This you observe that one. This is a zero. This is a zero. It is a meaning that one. There is no error here. That one. There is no positive error. There is no negative error we have. So now we go for the take the reading. How to take the reading? We go for that one. So here we have to observe that one. Which means. So generally, general terms, we are going to tell about a least count that one in when you are going for that one screw gauge and vernier calipers. So you learn in the terms we are going to learn that one. So generally, for one rotation, how many tons will going to take out here that one? So generally, I am going to observe that one here on round scale 0 to 100 we have 0. So carefully observe that one 0. And 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90. And here that one we have heard. For one complete rotation. So I will move it like this, complete rotation. So one complete rotation here, observe that one. So this is, I am going for the complete rotation. Okay, generally we are going for that one. I start with the 0. See that one, I start with the 0, that one. Here exactly 0, here observe that one, 0, exactly. I'll go for the complete rotation means when I will come back to zero here that one. So rotate, it reaches here that one exactly at zero. Now we're going to observe that one, it is going to zero. So here one line is crossed exactly. See, observe that one. One line is crossed here. Yeah, one line is crossed. That what you are observing here, that one line is crossed. Zero after one line is crossing means that one. So it is the consider that one 1 by, so total rotations means one rotation we have that one, means one rotation means 100 on the round scale we have, that I consider that one 1 by 100. So 1 by 100 is a 0.01, it is in millimeter. So millimeter you generally observe that one, it is millimeter, they convert it into centimeter. 0.001 centimeter is your general at least count, that is called in pitch that one. How to take out the reading that one? First you go for that one. First factor we will go for that one here. Reading on the glass plate. Okay. So now I'll take out here that one. Now I'll keep it here. So on the glass plate. So generally we observe that one. So same way I have to do that one here. So I'll going to touch this one. Try to touch that one. So now I'm try to touch downside surface. Okay, it is going to touch nearly. So check with paper that one. So it is touched or not? Yeah, it's the screw downside you are going to observe that one. The paper is not going to move from one side to other side. And legs also check out. No, legs also it is like that. It is all the three legs and the screw it touch on the surface. Just you observe that one. Okay. Then you start take the readings that one. What is the takes the reading that one here? So just you take out the reading here that one. Observe what you have that one. This the scale is exactly at zero. Okay, this is the scale we are going to observe that one. The 50. So just you observe that one here. Is the 50. So it is a 51 is exactly matching that one. Means I have read here that one. What is the reading that one? So on vertical scale it is the reading is zero. Generally, so and round scale, what is the reading is 51, and main what is the least count here? That one discount is 0.001 here. That one now I'll go for total reading here. I'm calculating 0 plus 51 into 0 means what is that one 0.051. So this is the reading that one what you got that one. So 50. When I multiply that one head round scale and this is least count what you are going in that one, so 0.051. just you want to see that one in calculator, you go and see that one. That is 51 into 0.01 is 0.051. okay, add with a zero that one, then same value you are getting that one, means 0.051 what you got here that one. Okay, clear. Now this is the value what I got that one reading on the glass plate. So I got reading that one. So I'll take out that one, I'll place here that one curved surface and I'll keep it beside that one. So I'll go for that one. Curved surface is upside, is a plane surface, correct? This is the curved surface you have. Okay, it's a curved surface, the plane surface. Now curved surface I will try to place here that one. So on the curved surface, now when I'm try to place here that one, it is not properly sitting that one. Okay, so it is three legs are not properly sitting that one. Now slowly what you have to do that one, loose it screw up to that one, that three legs will going to sit on the lens. Now even though you have some, it is not sitting properly. Now you observe that one. Now I'm try to move this one, it properly sit that one. Just using the check the paper, using that one, using the paper check, you have to go for that one. I'm checking that one. No, so I'm checking that one. Yeah, so I'm checking here three legs. Yes, okay, I'm checking this one paper using the checking paper. Now it is properly arranged that one. Now I'll go for the calculations. So reading on the curved surface, the second part, what you have that one reading on the curved surface. Okay, now I'll go for that one. What is the value here, that one? What is the value? So on main scale it is a, in main scale what you are going to hear that one, in vertical scale the value is zero, the value is same here, that one the same it exactly. Now I'm saying that one the value of the here the reading, so we have to see that one, that value is a zero exactly. Okay, now on vertical scale and you know that one least count is 0.001. what I have that one on vertical scale, what is the value here that one vertical scale? Now you are going to observe this is the 10, this is the 11, 12, exactly the value is exactly 12. Just observe that one, the value is 12. Now I am writing here that one 12 value, 12 value. So just you go for that one. What is that one? 12 into, so in calculator 12 into 0.001. okay, so what you are allocating 0.012, you are getting that one. So 0 plus 0.012 value is are getting, means total value is 0.012. now I'm going to add that one, I'm getting that one. So I subtract that one. So now I want that one height h, I want. So I'll subtract the values of this one, values of what is that one reading on the curved surface. Okay, so reading on the glass plate, that one. These two I'll going to subtract. I'll get some value, that one. Now I'll try to subtract that one on that one. Okay. Now on glass plate you have that one. So anything, that one. This one, this one positive, you take out that one. So 0.051. Okay. I'm taking the value 0.012. Curved surface on the glass plate 0.51. Yeah, I'll subtract that one. Anything, that one, I got that one value. So 0.051 minus 0.012. What I got a value? 0.039. I got value. That is a H. What I got have value, that one, 0.039. I substitute here that one. And that is in, what is L, that one? L means the distance between the any three legs, that one means any two legs I have taken, that one L. So just you place out here that one. Using the scale, you have to find out what is the value of this L, that one. Now I am going to find out what is the value here, that one. So generally I'll use the scale, and I'm going to measure the what is that one value of that one. So the two legs distance, that one. Okay. If you do it, that one, three legs distance, and do it average, that one, it is a three legs distance is same, that one. Now I'm observing here that one. Yeah, what is that one? It is exactly the two legs here. The distance is, I have marked here points. Then I'm observing that one. The marked is point. One point here, one point here means one leg. This is the one leg distance here, the marked here, and another leg distance is marked here like this. Okay, like this I marked here. So then I find that one here to here is a 4 centimeters. Then I'm writing L value is a 4 centimeters. Okay, 4 square. Then 6 into 0.039 plus 0.039 by 2. Now do it for the calculation. Go for the calculations. So go for that one. Okay. So now I'll go for the calculation. So here go for the calculations. So 4 square means 16 into. Now I'll go for the calculations here. That one, 6 into 0.039. What I got, that one value is 0.234 exactly. What I got, that one. So next value is 0.039 divided by 2. What I got answer, 0.0195. And what I got, that one value of that one, 16 divided by 0.234. So now I got the value, some value I got 68. I got that one 68.37 plus 0.0195, that I got that one. So answer plus 0.0195, what I got value is 68.3. In the total value, what I got, that one, your R value, radius of curvature. So 68.395 I got, that one. 68.395, what I got answer, that one. Means your radius of curvature R is equal to 68. If you more than 5, I take out 69. I have to go for that one. I have that one. Means radius of curvature you got 68. What is this one? Centimeters. Okay. So now radius of curvature for this particular lens, I got that one radius of curvature 68. Now use this radius of curvature R value 68 and replace that one inside the Newton-Ring's formula. So what is the Newton-Ring's formula here, that one? You know that one, Newton-Ring's formula? So Newton-Ring's formula, you had to find out the wavelength lambda is equal to. So dm square minus dn square by 4r into m minus n. Okay. In last class, we have discussed about how we got that one graph from graph. Dm square value and m and n value. The r value, what do you have the formula r value? What you got here, that one? So from the calculation 68, I got that one. Just substitute here this 68 and we are getting that one, the lambda value exactly. So sodium wavelength, we are using generally calculator in your laboratory, sodium wavelength lamp is a fixed value. You have wavelength 5893 angstroms. You have to get this value exactly. You are getting by substituting this r value and dm square, nth ring of diameter, nth ring of diameter, nth ring values you have substituted from the graph. Exactly lambda value will going to match here 5893. Sometimes you will get that on 587, 588, 58. After that one 88 something value you are getting. Exactly acceptable, these values are acceptable, that one, that is this is the way you have to find out the radius of curvature in Newton rings. Okay, follow this video and do it properly, that one Newton rings experiment. Thank you.